Business to the next level? Let us introduce you to Suede Soul AI Business Video Creation. Our techno robot intelligent creativity soul professional field soul aging content planning itemize the tape to web. Being deaf.
The steal by DeMonte. Does a great job of staying in bounds. DeMonte to the bucket. Up and good. It's a four-point game.
Welcome to Suede Soul, another edition of Suede Soul, and we got an incredible guest for you today, Mr. Joe Newman. And I don't even want to begin to talk about the many talents and give him a moniker in one place, because this man is incredible. Mr. Newman, I want to thank you for being on the Suede Soul show today. How are you today?
I'm really good, Harold, and I really appreciate you having me on. It's very nice and very nice.
So no, I wanna, you know, I've known you for a long time. This gentleman here has been a mentor to me. He's taught me a lot of things when it came to just even in business and marketing, on the ways we have connected with each other. He's become a friend, someone I've known for over a decade. So, you know, with all that being said, I wanna bring him into the show and get right down to it, Mr. Newman. So let's talk about, you know, I wanna start off right off and let everybody who know who Joe Newman is. So let's talk about your childhood. So give us an insight on how you started in this life living lesson, and tell us about Joe Newman in that essence.
Well, I appreciate, you know, you're being very modest, Harold. I've really enjoyed having you as part of the ABA for the last 10, 12, 13 years. And as I've said to you and to many people many times through the years, you're probably one of the brightest, most perceptive people that we've ever had in the ABA. So I feel it's just terrific to have you a part of the ABA, a part of my life. Good man. That being said, I'm 83 years old, Harold, and I've been I've retired in 1983. I've retired in 1996. I came out of retirement to start with the ABA with a partner who was the co-founder of the original ABA and the co-founder of the original Indiana Pacers. But going way back, I am from New York. Even though I was born in Baltimore, we consider ourselves New Yorkers because my parents were, and my dad was in broadcasting, so we traveled around the country, and it happened to be at a very short period of time when he was in Baltimore that I was born, and when the next day went back to New York. They were both very liberal people, and they, way before the subject of civil rights existed, it did exist, but in the very earliest days, they hated discrimination, they hated bigotry, they hated racism, and they raised my eight brothers and sisters, there were nine of us, to have the same feelings. And they were very vocal long before the Civil Rights Act, long before much of the changes that developed in the 60s and into the 50s and 40s. They were very outspoken about their lack of tolerance for anyone who was intolerant. And so wherever we went, and because Dad was in broadcasting, we not only lived in New York, but we lived in many parts of the Deep South, lived in Louisiana, we lived in Mississippi, we lived in Florida, we lived in Virginia, in the height of segregation and the height of where racism really reared its ugly heads. But my four brothers and sisters and I did not believe in that. And as a result of that, we very early on respected people for who they are, not the color of their skin, not their religion, not their nationality. And that's the way we grew up. And that became a part of our life. And because we were not wealthy, but fairly well-to-do, much of the time, even though we lived in the Bronx and we lived in Brooklyn, where there was much more integration during that period, we lived on Long Island on the North Shore and did not have every day direct exposure to the Black community or the Hispanic community, but we certainly did when we were in New Orleans or Waveland, Mississippi, or Gulfport, Mississippi, or Jacksonville, Florida, West Palm Beach, Florida, Richmond and Petersburg, Virginia. So we really saw racism at its worst and were very strong against it. And that's as a young person, that's the way we felt. But I did not have a chance to really make an impact in that area until I was a little bit older and shortly after I went into the ad agency business, when I ultimately, after I got out of the Army, came to Indianapolis, Indiana, which was so proud of the lack of African Americans in the city, so proud that they were not like, quote, New York, Chicago, Detroit, Cleveland, as if that was a badge of honor because they did not have the problems that Philadelphia, Baltimore, et cetera, were having with the fact that they were growing numbers and percentages of the African-American or the Black population. So when I came here and I saw that, I said, just out of the Army, very, very young, I said, you know what? I'm going to change this. I'm going to change this, okay? No Black radio station, no Blacks in radio and TV, redlining of houses, and a myriad of other things that bothered me as an individual. And so I started to do something about it. And I think at that particular point, I started to make a difference. Early on, I was one of the people behind Indiana Black Expo, which became the largest Black Expo in the country. The first year they had it, when Reverend Sanders and Charles Williams had it, it was a show that was exactly opposite of what the Black community should be doing. There was a lot of music, there was a lot of sports, and there was no substance. And it bothered me because they were creating and perpetuating the same stereotype the Black America was mired in. And so I said, look, in order for this to be relevant, we need to talk about subjects that you're not talking about. And it includes economic empowerment, and included education, and it included housing, and it faced directly into the systemic racism that existed, even though here it was sort of under the table. We had to bring it out in the open, and we need to put relevancy into Black Expo. And fortunately, because I had an ad agency with some power at that point, I was able to bring very bright young people who went on to great careers in Indianapolis in broadcasting and community and involvement and social changes and justice, so that Indianapolis really improved dramatically and helped bring the first radio, Black radio station, on the air, WTLC Radio, which became one of the great models of Black radio in the United States, and got great people into broadcasting and great people into advertising agencies and TV and radio sales, and caught the attention of a lot of people. So ultimately, my ad agency, which was pretty good, and I handled a lot of very big accounts, my ad agency became representative of all the developing Black business that came in Indianapolis. So I really prospered from it, but I didn't do it because of that. It turned out to be that way. And I think Indianapolis became better for it. And I started to get a lot of accolades for what I was doing, and not the kind of resistance that one might have expected. Why? because what I had was economic clout. I mean, radio stations and TV stations and businesses could not say no to me because I had a large advertising agency. Well, I became the ad agency of the Home Builders Association. And guess what? Home building started to bring it into the Black community. I helped start the first Black bank in Indianapolis, Midwest National Bank, and explained how set-asides worked and minority investments worked and so forth. And subsequently, I was able to generate some economic clout and put some pressure on the other banks and to make an impact on the redlining that was going on because I was handling most of the major subdivisions in Indianapolis. And so all of that really gave me the opportunity to do what I always wanted to do. And then the Indiana State Police was sued because of their lack of minority recruitment. And they came to me because I was known for what I'm doing and said, we need to put a class of Black trainees into the academy because we have been sued to increase the number of minority members of the Indiana State Police. And so Superintendent DeBard gave me $100,000. And I said, okay, I spent $20,000, but I did not do it in a racial way. I used media, but not the message. The message was we were looking for good people, but I used the media in Fort Wayne and in the Northeast Indiana and Gary and Hammond and in Evansville and of course in Indianapolis. And we put in 40 minorities and women into the academy. And when that happened, that graduating class of 40 Black troopers graduated with the second highest grade in the history of the academy. And they all look like Quinn Buckners. I mean, I had an army of beautiful people. But as I said to the Superintendent DeBard, who was a good man, and his successor, Superintendent Shuttle, I said, the problem you have is you have white troopers all over Indiana, and we don't know whether they can accept Black troopers or not, and we don't know whether their captains and their assignees are going to treat these people properly. So I said, what I want to do is I want to have sensitivity training, and I want to go in and just meet with all the Black troopers around the United States to be able to integrate these wonderful young people that I brought into the academy into the Indiana State Police. Well, the FBI heard about that. And so the FBI hired me, took me to Washington and flew me in on the FBI's plane. And I get to explain not to J. Edgar Hoover or whoever was in there at the time, what I was doing and why not only the recruitment of minorities was important to law enforcement, but notice I'm married, but also that they had to be brought into it as full-fledged members, treated properly and not put in to Black areas and putting Black troopers in the Black areas while all the white troopers were going into the white areas. I said, what you need to do is give them some sensitivity training. And because the troopers are good people, I'm talking about the white troopers, are good people, but never really had an opportunity to have anybody talk to them like that. The way they brought them in was so good. Ultimately, one of my graduates, I'm not calling them my graduates, but one of my graduates ultimately became the superintendent of the Indiana State Police. That's how good they were. And they became commanders and lieutenants and exhibited the same qualities they had as part of the academy. So, wow. To me, that's one of the highlights of my career, but it really didn't stop there. It really started there. And
well, you're right. And I want to ask the question about your interaction with one of the most famous people that we all know is KFC, Colonel Sanders. Tell a story on how your interaction with Colonel Sanders came
about. Well, That's really an interesting question. I got out of the Army and came here from Greenville, South Carolina, where I was on WFBC TV at that time. And I did television shows, real estate shows in different cities. And I happened to go to Greenville, South Carolina, didn't like it here. And I worked with my dad, who has since passed away. And we had a show called The House Detective. And he and I was very good at selling realtors and builders to come on that show. And he said, Joe, why don't you go to Indianapolis, Indiana? I'd never heard of Indianapolis, but go to Indianapolis, Indiana, and we'll put the show on there and then see if you can open up additional shows in additional cities. So I opened up shows in St. Louis, Minneapolis, Detroit, Indianapolis, and Wheeling, West Virginia. This before videotaping or during the early days of videotaping. And I did the shows in all of those markets. I actually drove one day around this cycle in the Midwest and did The House Detective. I made nice money, had a good time. And my son Bobby was born. And I said to my dad, I don't want to be gone 5 days a week. Or my wife had become pregnant with my first son. And I said, I want to be home more. And he said, no, you have to do all these shows. I said, no, let's hire people to do those shows, but I'm not going to do this anymore. So I went to work as a salesperson for a local television station that had been trying to recruit me because they couldn't understand how my television show, my 1 hour House Detective, had more advertisers on it than the entire station had on it, what I was doing as a salesperson. So I went to that TV station, the local CBS affiliate, and had a job, and I worked there for 17 months. And during that period, one of my largest accounts, an automobile company, a used car dealer, who was spending at that time $250,000, $500,000 a year, which at that time was a big budget for automobiles, said to me one day, kid, how come I don't get to advertise on the other TV stations like I used to? And I said, I'm gonna go get some more.
The bakery sensation. Oh, 90 cakes, the sweetest creation. Bless the cupcakes, an explosion of delight. Bite into one and you'll forget all your plans. Sugar rush, oh, what a thrill. Oh, 90 cakes, they give you the chill. With every bite, your taste buds away. Indulging the goodness of a sweet mistake.
What's my name? It's Shimon in the zone. I'm here to bring the heat, make you feel it in your bones. Smooth like butter, got the ladies in a frenzy. When I step on the stage, you know it's gonna be sizzling.
Shimon, Shimon, that's my name. Gonna make you groove, gonna make you swing.
Ooh, yeah.
Shimon, Shimon, watch me flow. When I'm on the mic, you already know. I'm cruising through the night like a star shooting bright. With rhymes so tight, I'm the talk of every site. I glide across the floor with moves you can't ignore. Bringing vibes so pure, I'm the one you've been waiting for.
Shimon, Shimon, feel the beats. Dancing in your heart, moving your feet.
Let's move.
Shimon, Shimon, feel the heat. Riding on the rhythm.
From the east to the west, I'm passing every test with a style so fresh. They say I'm one of the best. No need to contest when I'm on the quest to keep the crowd blessed with this musical flesh. Yeah. Back in the game of fame, my middle name. Lyrics so flame, they're lighting up your brain. With every verse I craft, I'm charting my own path, leaving the legacy that's bound to forever last.
Shimon,
Shimon, Shimon, it's a vibe. With every note I sing, I bring the crowd alive.
Oh yeah.
Shimon, Shimon, can't deny. With every beat I drop, I'm soaring sky high, 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 high. Shimon, Shimon, it's a vibe. With every note I sing, I bring the crowd alive. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Shimon, Shimon, can't deny. With every beat I drop, I'm soaring sky high, 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 high. Shimon, Shimon, it's a vibe.
The steal by Demonte does a great job of staying in bounds. Demonte to the bucket, up and good. It's a 4-point game.
Oh, by Regina Mason.
Herman Suazo, his first, Pete's first, shooting two for Massachusetts, Savon Houston. Second.
a bakery sensation. Oh, not eat cakes, the sweetest creation. Melissa cupcakes, an explosion of delight. But if you want it, you'll forget all your pride. Sugar rush, oh, what a thrill. Whole nutty cakes that give you the chill. With every bite your taste buds away. Indulge in the goodness of a sweet mistake.
Steal by DeMonte. Does a great job of staying in bounds. DeMonte to the bucket, up and good. It's a 4-point game.
Thank you for sponsoring the Martins all season long. Nick Simpson, his first, team's first.
Bell number 8, Nick Simpson is second, team second. Shooting 2 for the Martins, Todd Spotwoods. Violation, Bennington ball. Media timeout. Number 3, Tyler Mitchell, his first, fourth. number 24, Terrell Kemp, his first team sniff.
Thank you.
At the end of one, Bennington leads the Wolves 20-12. Again, the Martins would like to thank the following sponsors: NAACP, the Rutland. Tyler Mitchell, his second, team's first in the quarter. Shooting two, Aaron Struthers.
Oh!
Traveling violation, Martin's ball. For Terrell Camp, his second, Dean's second, shooting two, Savon Houston. Seven, Mark Sidbury, his first team serve. Shooting two, Nick Simpson. Pickle for two. Foul number 32, Savon Houston, his first, Pete's first. Shooting in one, Todd Spotswood. His first, Dean's fourth, shooting two, Aaron Struthers. Media timeout. And the Martin would like to thank the following sponsors for this evening.
His first team second.
Come on, man.
2-2, Anthony Mitchell. Mitchell, his first team spin.
Let's move!
2, Hannah Whitehead. We'll be right back. Brett Murphy. At the end of two, Bennington leads the Wolves 49-36.
The bakery sensation. Oh, 90 cakes, the sweetest creation. Melissa cupcakes, an explosion of delight. Bite into one and you'll forget all your plans. Sugar rush, oh, what a thrill. Oh, 90 cakes, they give you the chill. With every bite, your taste buds away. In the goodness of a sweet mistake.
My name, it's Jamon in the zone. I'm here to bring the heat, make you feel it in your bones. Smooth like butter, got the ladies in a frenzy. When I step on the stage, you know it's gonna be sizzling.
Jamon, Jamon, that's my name. Gonna make you groove, gonna make you swing.
Ooh, yeah.
Jamon, Jamon, watch me flow. When I'm on the mic, you already know. Through the night like a star shooting bright. With rhymes so tight, I'm the talk of every site. I glide across the floor with moves you can't ignore. Bringing vibes so pure, I'm the one you've been waiting for.
Shimon, Shimon, feel the beats. Dancing in your heart, moving your feet.
Let's move.
Shimon, Shimon, feel the heat. Riding on the rhythm, never missing a beat.
Come on, come on, come on, come on.
From the east to the west, I'm passing every test. With a style so fresh, they say I'm one of the best. No need to contest when I'm on the quest. To keep the crowd blessed with this musical fest. Back in the game with fame, my middle name. Lyrics so flame, they're lighting up your brain. With every verse I craft, I'm charting my own path. Leaving a legacy that's bound to forever last.
Shimon, 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 it's a vibe. With every note I sing, I bring the crowd alive. Shimon, Shimon, can't deny. With every beat I drop, I'm soaring sky high. Shimon, Shimon, it's a vibe. With every note I sing, I bring the crowd alive. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Shimon, Shimon, can't deny. With every beat I drop, I'm soaring sky high. Shimon, Shimon, it's a vibe.
I was down last year, up, and you know he bout to bomb. All like Kobe in his prime, take it away, it's my time. Day after day, night after night, gotta move right. Anywhere, I be rocking my eyes, playing games, till you better think twice. I was down on my love, I know the hate, cause I'm up.
Close my gram, stop minding my sh. You wanna go live, I drill them on Twitch. Not ops, n***s or kids, n***s not tough, n***s or. Put them on songs, I give them more hits. I put them on plays, I make them all rich. Three or four, I make them all kiss. I see an op, I shoot it to a clip. You better leave or we rob you. You better watch who you lie to. Came in a spot with a little Uzi. I wanna rock too. I see them, they copying my moves. You wanna be litty, I got you. I ain't running from bullets, I'm not you. You ain't shoot the little n***a who shot you. I'm from the city, I'm coming to Philly. Tell the club I need 150. Got a gun in here, I bring it in with me. Don't search my b***h, cause under her. I see them n***a, I gotta get busy. I'm off a b***h, so I'm hot and I'm dizzy. But I'm on point cause they plotting to get me. But D got the c***a and he rocking the whip.
Get with me, bulletproof truck when I move to the city. Rocking all my tens, you know them hitters is with me. I was down last year, up, and you know he bout to bomb. All like Kobe in his prime, take it away, it's my time. Day after day, night after night, gotta move right. Anywhere, I be rocking my eyes, playing games, yeah, you better think twice. I was down on my love, I know the hate cause I'm up. Whoa, when you hear that sound, oh boy, right now. Oh boy, right now. Right now, when you hear that sound, oh boy, right now. Oh boy, right now. Right now.
The steal by DeMonte does a great job of staying in bounds. DeMonte to the bucket, up and good. It's a 4-point game.
my name, it's a moon in the zone. I'm here to bring the heat, make you feel it in your bones. Smooth like butter, got the ladies in a frenzy. When I step on the stage, you know it's gonna be sizzling. Shalom, shalom, that's my name. Gonna make you move, gonna make you swing. Ooh, yeah. Shalom, shalom, watch me flow. When I'm on the mic, you already know. I'm cruising through the night like a star shooting bright. With rhymes so tight, I'm the talk of every sight. I glide across the floor with moves you can't ignore. Bringing vibes so pure, I'm the one you've been waiting for.
Shalom, shalom, feel the beats. Dancing in your heart, moving your feet.
Let's move. From the east to the west, I'm passing every test with a style so fresh. They say I'm one of the best. No need to contest when I'm on the quest to keep the crowd blessed with this musical fest. Back in the game of fame, my middle name. Lyrics so flame, they're lighting up your brain. With every verse I craft, I'm charting my own path, leaving a legacy that's bound to forever last.
Shalom, 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 it's a vibe. With every note I sing, I bring the crowd alive. Shalom, shalom, can't deny. With every beat I drop, I'm soaring sky high, 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 high. Shalom, shalom, it's a vibe. With every note I sing, I bring the crowd alive. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Shalom, shalom, can't deny. With every beat I drop, I'm soaring sky high, 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 high. Shalom, shalom.
Houston, turn two. Put for two.
Defense!
Average one fourth row and his third team's first reporter. Devon Houston for two. Media timeout. Sweet mistake.
Thank you.
Foul number 6, Charles Mitchell, his first. Team's third.
Thank you.
Steal by DeMonte, does a great job of staying in bounds. DeMonte to the bucket, up and good. It's a 4-point game.
Foul number 15, Herman Suazo, his third, team six.
I was down last year, up, and you know you about to bomb. While I call you on the crown, take it away, it's my time. Day after day, night after night, gotta move right. Anywhere, I be rocking my eyes, playing games, till you better think twice.
put them on songs, I give them more hits. I put them on plays, I make them all rich. 3 or 4, I make them all kiss. I see an opp, I shoot it to a clip. You better leave or we rob you. You better watch who you lie to. Came in the spot with a little Uzi. I wanna rock too. I see them, they copy in my moves. You wanna be litty, I got you. I ain't running from bullets, I'm not you. You ain't shoot the little n***a who shot you. I'm from the city, I'm coming to Philly. Set a club, I need 150. Got a gun in here, I bring it in with me. Don't search my bitches, I'm the hut. I see them, I gotta get busy. I'm over, so I'm hot, I'm dizzy. But I'm on point, cause they probably get me. But he got the gun and he rockin' the whip.
You with me? Bulletproof track when I move to the city. Bringin' all my chains, you know what them hitters is with me. I was down last year, up, and you know you bout to bomb. All like Kobe in his crown. Take it away, it's my time. Day after day, night after night, gotta move right anyway.
It's the fourth quarter.
Like after
half
Chris Green for three. Foul number 24, Terrell Camp, his fourth, Keats first in the quarter.
That's their top
quarter! Morgan Brown to three.
Come on,
number 22, Aaron Struther, is his third and team's first of the quarter. Shooting two, Mark Sidbury.
To take your business to the next level, let us introduce you to Swathe Soul AI Business Video Creation. Our techno robot intelligence soul professional field. Web.
Actually, nice. Wait. Come. What?
Foul number 6, Charles Mitchell, his second, team's third. Shooting 2, Terrell Camp.
Push it off.
Oh!
38, round for three.
Thank you.
Bring it down to the floor. Bell number 32, Siobhan Houston.
Don't play yourself 33. Don't tell nobody twice.
His second, Team Smith Media.
So you can play. I got your new dance for y'all, Kyle the Soulja Boy. You got a punch there, crack back through time from left to right.
Let go of the ball. That's all you know. What do you want to say? What do you want to say? 313. That's all I got.
Thank you. a bakery sensation. Oh, naughty cakes, the sweetest creation. Bless the cupcakes, an explosion of delight. Bite into one and you'll forget all your plight. Sugar rush, oh, what a thrill. Oh, naughty cakes, they give you the chill. With every bite, your taste buds awake. Indulging the goodness of a sweet mistake.
Let's go, Blue! Take it! fourth game to play.
How many minutes? You get the same amount of time, right? For overtime?
Overtime, I think it's five.
And you know he bout to bomb. While like Kobe in his prime. Take it away, it's my time. Day after day, night after night. Gotta move right. Anywhere I be rocking my eyes. Playing games till you better think twice. I was down on my love. I know the hate cause I'm up.
You my gram, stop minding my You wanna go live, I drill them on Twitch. Not ops, kids. Not tough, so put them on songs, I give them more hits. I put them on plays, I make them all rich. Grip all, so I make them all kiss. I see an op, I shoot it to a click. You better leave or we rob you. You better watch who you lie to. Came in the spot with a little Uzi. I wanna rock too low. I see him, they copying my moves. You wanna be Liddy, I got you. I ain't running for bullets, I'm not you. You ain't shoot the little
music. It was in the middle of the floor, on the Superman and everything.
Music. What's up, Blue?
Oh,
Let's go!
Of the Martins will be joining us today.